Good, Stacy. How are you?
Good. I just wanted to talk to you a little bit today about your training with Richard Heinz. First, can you tell us why did you call our company? What was your reasoning?
Well, I've had dogs for years, and before I got Kane, my dogs were always very, very sociable, and my house here was like a doggy daycare. All my friends would bring their dogs over and drop them off for the day, and I'd swim and play with them, and it was just a blast. And then I got Kane, and at that point I had 3 labs. And he was a show dog, so he was very socialized. He was really good until he started getting up between 1 and 2, and he started showing this aggression towards males. So it got to the point where at the shows, it was kind of obvious. So I started being apprehensive about bringing any dogs over. Then I would, on my walks with him, I would walk him, and any dog he saw, and the aggression would come out. And I would be pulling them, and he would be trying to get to them. And I was to the point where I was like, okay, I'm going to walk them when there's nobody around. I hope we don't see any dogs. I hope we don't have anything, you know. So it was becoming an inconvenience. And I've tried a behaviorist in the past, and I got some results as far as being able to walk him better. But I didn't get the interaction like with Richard, where we were exposed to different dogs and we could really see if it was working, and I could see a difference in him. So I heard about Richard, and I heard of...
How did you hear about Richard?
I heard about him through Mark Dax.
Okay.
Mark Dax. And he had an aggressive, I think, Australian Shepherd. And he started saying that he was working with him and how he could run with him off leash. And I was like, oh my God, I don't even care about off leash. I just want to be able to walk and not have being pulled down the street. And so, and I wanted to have dogs over because that's a big part of my life. So it did change my life a lot, because it became where I didn't really take him out much. My other dogs, we took them to dinner. They'd go everywhere with us, but not him. So we became, I don't know, not stuck at home, but we didn't socialize as much. So found Richard, and from the first class, he started working with him, and he started responding very well to walking, and whichever way you go, he goes. And second class, he brought a dog, a white German Shepherd, beautiful dog, and I was just like amazed. It was a male, and I think maybe Kane had one little growl, and that was it.
So you noticed the difference immediately. After mm-hmm. the first class, you saw a difference.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Can I ask you, what did you notice that was different about Richard's training and philosophy that you had noticed about, you know, other trainers in the past? What makes him different? What was different?
Okay, first of all, the psychology. He knows the psychology of the dog. It's like he knows what those dogs are thinking, and like everything that we think they're thinking and that we want to do is the opposite of what's supposed to be. So I found his training just fascinating to me. The psychology of it, and understanding what the dog's thinking, and it's the opposite of what we're thinking. And I was just amazed by the rapport that he has with the dogs, and the way they respond to him. And I was fascinated. I just couldn't get over it. I haven't seen that before, and I have had different trainers.
Okay. How did you know, and how were you convinced that Richard's training has taken hold? What evidence did you see?
My God. Well, I can tell you right now, the other night I had two Goldens over here, a male and a female. We had like a little dog party. And I've been going to the park. Never in my life did I think I could take him to a park. And he hasn't reacted. He hasn't growled. I was staying at my friend's house a week ago with him. Perfect. It's another male and female. And Richard has told me, I've always focused on the males because that's what I saw. But Richard said it's all across the board. You know, he has a fear aggression, and it's not, it can come out with the females too. I had just never witnessed that. So now those dogs come over to my house. They come inside. He wasn't upset. They were, you know, all over us, you know, wanted the attention. He was fine. So that's a huge, huge step. I want to invite more dogs over. And going to the park is just like, never in my life did I think we could take him to a park.
Do you see him? She came to share waters.
She was with Kane.
Oh, good boy. Good boy, buddy.
She's like, give me more of your baby.
She sees us often, like,
the first time, I was like, okay. I'm even going to take him to the doggy yappy hour that's starting this week.
Really?
Yeah.
Excellent. That's great. So from the classes with working with Richard, you've achieved everything that you hoped for.
Yes. I just want to keep doing it. I want to keep exposing him more and more and more, because now, when I walk him now, first of all, he walks right with me. He stops with me. He pays attention to me. The other day, we're walking. My aunt was here. She saw for the first time ever. Little dog crossed the street, you know, just barking, just trying to get to him. Kane looked, walked along. Now, in the past, it would have been, I would have braced myself. I would have held the leash like this, and I would have just waited until they went by so that we could move on. Okay. Huge difference.
Right. Okay. One thing I wanted to ask you about Richard and his psychology. Were you surprised by it? Did it surprise you? Tell me a little bit about how you interpreted his psychology with dogs.
Okay, I was amazed by it. I was fascinated by it. Okay, I started listening to what he was saying about how the dog's mind gets like they get stuck on something. It gets locked, and you got to snap them out of it. Snap them out of it. And I said to him while we were talking, I said, you know, this sounds like OCD to me, in a person. You know, when they get like an obsession, they can't get it out of their head, and it just keeps going and going and going, and you got to snap it out. And he said, yes, it's very similar. So that I found fascinating, because out of all the trainers I've ever been to, I never have heard anything like that. So I could understand what he was saying. And then he told me, like with Kane, for example, with Kane, who's like the biggest lover, teddy bear, you know, doll, he has the fear. So it was like just needing to build his confidence to show that all dogs aren't bad. They're not going to all come after you. You know, you can actually play with them. You can actually, you know, socialize a little bit. And so that was the biggest thing for me, was I was so interested in his psychology that I keep telling him, when are you going to write a book? When are you going to get a TV show?
Great. Well, let's go.
Go, Kane. Go. Go get it, buddy. Go.
Half the time he wants me in there and I swing with him to get it.
Yep.
Hey, you gotta go faster. He's beating you.
Aww. This is great.
You just take your time, huh?
Aww.
He's just so.
Dude, he's like, listen, I'm out for a leisurely swim, lady.
Exactly.
Awesome.